Hi, Mark Diaz here for 2DAnimation101.com. In this lesson, I'm gonna show you really quick how you can create an animated comic. Okay, so if you want to download the files to check this project, you can just go to 2D101.com/animated comic. In there, you're gonna get a file like this, this zip file. Once you uncompress it, you're gonna get these two folders. One is images. These are the images we're gonna be using. It's just those three panels and a background, a simple background, and then Cartoon Animator 4. This is the one I'm gonna be using to record this lesson. But this is gonna be, if you want to follow along, you can just click here and play with this project, or you can see the end result. Okay, so right now, what I'm gonna do is go to Cartoon Animator 4 and then open Animated Comic Start. There you go. So what we have is just the three images imported. Now, they are not just imported, they already have the bones. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. And if I go to Scene Manager, I can just disable the other ones so I can just see only one by one. Let's start with this one. If I press K, you will see that this character already has bones. So I can just take those bones and then move him around like this, right? Now, if I want him to be doing a movement like this, like ducking a little bit, I need to be able to take that bone and move it down. The problem is that if I try to move it down, it only rotates. So what I can do is I can just go to the 2D motion key editor and then click on constraints. And now I can move this freely. So that's how this character can duck a little bit for the animation we're gonna be doing, like this. I can do this and then I can take this shoulder and lift it up if I want. That's for that rig. Now, the next one is this hero. I can also take this bone and then move him a little bit so he can be ducking, getting ready, and then an anticipation in which he ducks a little bit. And then at the end, let me hide hero rig 2 and then hero rig 3. And then, when you do this, you need to close the motion key editor and then hide and then show the other one and then K. There you go. And then he can be like this, ducking down a little bit. Actually, it has to be from this bone, like this. And then stepping out like very manly and maybe move the shoulders down a little bit when he does that, right? So he can be like a movement like from shoulders up and head down to the contrary, shoulders down and then head out like this. Okay, so that's something we can do. Now the question is, how do you prepare all of this? How you rig the bones and everything? Well, that is explained in detail in the course, the Mona Lisa, the course in which I animate the Mona Lisa. You set up the bones and then you just move them. It's super duper easy. In here, I'm gonna show you a speed run of how I did all this process. But right now, I just want to explain really high level. But if you're interested to learning how to do this in detail, then you can join us in the Cartoon Animator 4 training at 2D101.com/animating. And in there, you will get the how to animate a painting, and you will learn how to do this in detail. Now, right now, if we go to here, I'm going to undo everything I've done. Now, how can we appear and disappear this animation, each one of the panels? Well, here's how. You just open the timeline, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to select rig 3 and then hide it, and then rig 2 and then hide it. I'm hiding it not from the scene manager, but from the visibility switch, this one right here. Look. Why? Because that way, let me go in the timeline, I'm going to just hide everything. Let me just, I'm just clicking in everything. Okay, there it is. Now I'm going to select object related track. So it only chose Hero Rig 3. In here, I click on visible and it added this keyframe. Now I'm going to go to Rig 2. On Rig 2, I'm going to go to frame 30. And then on visible, I'm going to show Rig 2 like this. I just click on the eye. Pook. But at the same time, I want Hero Rig 1 to disappear. So I just select it and then click on the little eye and it disappears. So now we have this. We have this shot and then took it changes. I'm going to do the same on frame 125. On frame 125, I choose Hero Rig 3 and then I'm going to show it. And then select Hero Rig 2 and then hide it. There you go. Now we have this sequence. If I hit play, now it changes. That's the second, and then switch to the third. There you go. Now I can just take this and start animating. So that's how you do it, and that's how you can do a motion comic. Again, if you want to know everything in detail, you can just take our training. But what I'm going to do right now is I'm gonna show you a speed run of how I did all the animation and the rigging for this, the freebone rigging. Okay, let me play that clip when I did this. And that's how you can do an animated comic. Super easy to do this. So that's it for this video. Until next time, this is Mark Diaz for 2DAnimation101.com. Take care.